Awesome. Well, yeah, so I'm Ashley. For those of you who don't know me, I am a grad student in Tessa West and Mo Craig's labs. And because of this kind of like joint work, and also because I do a lot of interaction work, I have a lot of RAs. And this was something I wanted to share with you all because I feel like it was a struggle to kind of get a handle on managing a lot of people and being able to be present for a lot of people. And so I thought, why not talk to you about that? So that's what I'll hopefully give my insight about. And so basically, when I was thinking about it, I realized the main part of working with all these different people was being organized in like a Google Doc, or I guess in any sort of way. But it definitely kind of hinges on how I organize like all of the information that I was working with my RAs. And so that's why I'm going to just go through actually a lot of my documents through Google. So basically, I have like a one big file or folder where I have all of these different subfolders related to RAs. So I have DERF, honors thesis, letters of rec, MA thesis, et cetera. And I used to not have everything in one folder. This might seem really obvious to some people, but I didn't do that. And having it all together in one place is really helpful because then you can share that information with your RAs. And so what I'm first going to talk about is when I onboard an RA. And why I'm going to talk about that is because this is something that works for me. And so whenever I bring on an RA, I have them work with me for the first 2 weeks as sort of like a preliminary test phase. And I have them complete a Qualtrics task. And I don't give them a lot of information. I just give them these instructions here. And then I kind of just see how they work with me and with the other RAs in the lab to figure it out. I let them know that they can talk to me or their RAs, and I think it helps for me to see how they would be integrating into the lab and how they would learn and ask questions. So that's something that's worked for me, is having someone do a task like that just so that I can get a better handle before I tell someone, okay, we're gonna be working together for the next like couple of years and doing our master's thesis or whatever thesis. So yeah. Okay, so the next thing that I do is I'm gonna go into RA admin. And so I have like a lot of sort of tips that I've collected from students over the years. And so I try to just always keep those accessible to my RAs. So that way, that this is specific to working through COVID. So this is like working from home issues, common issues that come up. I have just like how to access things the server remotely, because that's what we have to do. For me, there's also, I find it really important to keep track of every single meeting that I have with my RAs. So I have one very big document, kind of like the document you all have for taking notes when you are giving presentations in lab. And I just have all of my RA meetings in that. So that way, if something comes up, then I know, okay, like we talked about that, or we didn't talk about that. Okay. So when it comes to like overall organization, I have implemented the use of a very large spreadsheet, and this works for me, but basically having like a general hub has been really helpful. So what I try to do is outline everything that I'm trying to work on for the next couple of, for basically the next semester, maybe 2 semesters. And I have all of my studies outlined and kind of like my plan for them. And then I actually like put in the different RAs who would be helping me with those. And I realize that this is really helpful for them to plan and then talk to me about what they have in their schedule. So like if they're having like a really rough week, that they know they're gonna have a rough week with like a lot of midterms or something, then we can have that all planned out with each other, and talk about like I can switch, you know, them with like another RA. Yeah. And so I also have an important date session here for me, as well as like RA trainings that I'm planning to do. So that way I can kind of plan to train everyone on almost all the same thing. And I used to kind of just train people by one thing at a time, depending on what they were working on. And now I realize it's actually just so much more helpful to plan a little bit more ahead and then make it so that I can have one session where in the beginning of the semester where I just train everyone on how to grant credit on Sona and things like that. So that's something that I think has really been a game changer for me. And then, so when it comes to this research goal sort of outline, then I also just have each of my RAs like take it and integrate it into their own little like section where they're just looking at what specific projects they'll be working on. And I have them talk about the goals that they have and whatever sort of work that they have going on. So if they're working on their thesis, what sort of deadlines those mean. And now I can integrate that into my planner so that I'm aware of like what their impending deadlines are. Okay, and so with that, I wanted to go to working on thesis with, on theses, I guess that's how you say it, I don't know. When you work on an MA thesis or you work on a student thesis, this is just kind of the process that I go through, and this is what I'll end on. So basically, what I have them read is, I think that Jay, you have students read this in one of your classes perhaps, but it's a, like a PDF on how to generate good research questions. And then I have kind of like a list of all the things that I expect of someone who is working on a thesis with me. And that is something that I've developed over time and I'm happy to share with anyone who would like it from me. But basically that's when I write out all of the deadlines. So some of the key things are they always send materials to me before they send the materials to like your advisor. You always have to reach out to me a month before a deadline to send me a reminder, because that's something for me that's really helpful. And whenever there's something that's due, you need to give that to me 2 weeks before the deadline so that I can have those, so that we can have those back and forths. And so I found that this was just really helpful to be very, very clear about what my expectations are for the grad student or the master student or for the RA. Because then we're on the same page and we're communicating about like what we want and expect from each other. So yeah, and I have like in this little folder that I'll share with everyone who works with me is like, I have any of my past students write down their tips for working on a thesis. And so I have them read through that and they can like reach out to those people if they need help or assistance on that. So yeah, that's basically it. Oh, I guess the one other thing that I'll throw in, this is just kind of like random tips for working with RAs, but Marine Craig has this nice little form where you have the RA share like specific information if they're requesting a letter of rec. And I just always use this form. I don't know if like this is used in your guys' lab, but this is just something that I always use no matter what. So that way I can like have a handle on like what's going on with my students before I'm writing them a letter of rec. So with that, I say thank you.